Welcome back, everyone, to The Inpatient.
Here with me, Patient Cox 47.
We're picking up where we last left off. I'm hoping I can get this done today now so I can delete this game off and that, because it's taking up space. But I'm hoping I can just finish it off and just have my recordings up and that. Do you know what I mean? Do you know when you just like want to finish a game off just so you can have all of the saved recordings, just as something you got to look back on? Shut up, David! I'm going home. Dude, I'm going home if you keep talking.
They should be waiting for me in his office.
Shut up.
I came out here to scope it out.
So straight away I'm going to say I'm sorry about my previous recording. Because do you know when you're in VR, if you want to time yourself on a recording, because I'm not doing it live and it's recorded, you have no way of timing yourself. Because even if you wanted to look at your watch dead. Right now, you look at your fucking arm in-game. So it's difficult to do. Oh, I love this area. Look at this. That's beautiful, that is. Just shines in. Look at that. Oh, God, there's blood on the floor. So, yeah. Hopefully we're going to go up here now, meet the rest of the gang again.
I haven't seen any of the miners since the incident.
No?
I still hear them, though. Mostly outside.
Yeah, whatever.
I think it's them.
Yeah.
Gives me the chills every time.
So, yeah. As for those of you that, like, I've been watching them, and, like, it's a bit back and forth with my videos, and you have no idea what the fuck I'm doing, I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm just going to give you a basic rundown on what the story is from what I've gathered that I haven't really, like, taken the time to explain to you guys. Basically, I'm in this mental asylum because even though I'm a patient, I'm actually a secret reporter that's come here to do a story. Something to do with, because this is, like, really old times. Well, not really old, but you know what I mean? This was years and years ago. And this is an old sanatorium for fucking nutters. But there's also a mining colony somewhere. I don't think it's part of this building. I could be wrong. I can't recall it is. Might be. But a lot of miners got sick with some sort of illnesses and started turning into Wendigos, which is from Until Dawn. Which is like these big skinny looking witch monster looking fucking thingies. They look horrible. Quite scary when you're face to face with one. It kicks off like that and they start swarming all over the sanatorium. You meet a little handful of survivors like David and Ted, Suzanne, and Gordo, isn't it? Good old Gordo. Oh, come on, buddy. Let's go. Yeah, so I do want to apologise for the previous recordings, because I don't know how to time, I can't time myself. The recording will just end, and I don't even get a chance to, like, to say, like, goodbye, or that's the end of it, that kind of thing. So it's just going to end. This one will more than likely just end abruptly, without me even realising. I'll cut off like the ending just as best as I can, just so it doesn't look that stupid. I'm in the middle of talking about that, like that shit. Like no, not having that. David, where are we going by? Hey, it's up to you.
Bragg was not exactly pleased. Someone called Bragg. The cops. I guess he's worried they'll catch a whiff of something they ain't supposed to.
Now Bragg. He likes to brag. We're in here again. The old fucking device. Look at it. David? Yo, man. Who's the man? It's cool the lighting effects, though, that you can do in VR.
Damn. Hearing about it's one thing. Seeing it, she was a good lady.
Yeah.
Didn't deserve that.
It's gonna get us all, man, if we're not careful.
Really, really not impressed with the controls to this game. The walking is terrible.
Every last fucking minor they see.
It's one of the worst controls I've ever played for a VR game, walking like this and turning. Like, gotta use this fucking hand to turn, like. Look at it. Don't even fucking respond. Look at that. It's fucking stupid, it is. I miss controls that you just press triangle and circle. I think it's triangle and circle, and then they just turn you left and right. I miss those. No, those were good. All right, where the fuck do you go? Oh, you're in here. Right. Hi there, bud. Let's go meet them. Oh. Okay. Oh, right. Chill. Oh, come on, boy.
And here we are.
Let's go. Meet him.
Nice hey, arms. It's David. Can I
nice
come in?
Arms. Nice piece of wood.
All right, so we got David,
Mr. Bragg,
Bragg.
Suzanne. Found someone else needs an escort.
Fucking nutter. Suzanne. Oh, she dies. This time. Now, remember last time? I sent her out first and she died. I'm going to go first this time.
Well, suffered the same fate as the others.
Aye.
You deceived me. You deceived me. You deceived me. My God, why didn't it pick up my voice? You deceived me. Jesus,
about
man.
About your roommate? Yes, Gordon is a dear friend and colleague. One of our staff doctors.
Hi.
Not a patient.
No.
I'm sorry, but the deception was necessary. I needed to observe your progress as closely
Aye.
As possible.
It's fine. I love Gordo anyway.
It's
He's brilliant.
It's all an effort to ensure your complete recovery.
Yeah, it's fine. I love
I
Gordo.
I know this is difficult.
He's a great guy.
But can you tell me if any more memories have resurfaced?
Bits and pieces.
Mm-hmm. Rest assured. Your memory will return. In time.
Yeah.
Though none of this really matters anymore.
Nope.
I should never have come back. Sorry, I thought I could right the ship. But you can't steer a ship in a squall.
Mr. Bragg, you've been down before. You'll pull us all through. I know you will.
Oh, Suzanne, my dear.
Yeah.
I admire
Good old Suzanne in her little white shoes.
But it's misplaced in me. This is, it's just too big to keep quiet.
Don't worry,
man. I'm finished.
No, Mr. Bragg, please, let's just go to the chapel. The storm's lit up. The police are on
yes.
their way.
The chapel.
Thank you.
Go now. I'm staying here.
We can't leave you behind. It's not safe.
No, we're not leaving him this time.
Please. You know we all have to go. Everyone, Bragg included.
That's true. Very true. Yes, he should come with us.
Stop! Enough! This place belongs to me.
No, it don't.
And I belong
yes.
to it. Now
no.
get the hell out of here.
Mr. Bragg.
Suzanne, stop. Come on. He's made up his mind.
No. No.
We gotta go now while we still can.
No. What the fuck happened to him, man? I'm not leaving, man. No.
Gordon. Careful with your charge. The right information at the wrong time can turn apples to sand.
I don't know what the hell that's supposed to mean. Don't forget who's really responsible for all this.
I believe I've made myself perfectly clear.
No.
Get the hell out of here and leave me alone.
No. Give me a... You should come with us.
Can't you just... All right, fine. All right. It's so important to you. Go on ahead and I'll catch up.
Yay!
I'll be right behind you.
Will you? Oh, you better fucking out, dude.
Just get out of here. There's only one thing in the world that will command my attention now. And it's inside this bottle.
Dude, you gotta come with us, man. Should fucking smash that bottle, the chance I had. So is he, like, meant to go with you then? Are you actually able to get the guy to go with you? No, no, pause. Fucking... Ah. I tried. I did. Oh, fucking hell. I actually tried, Suzanne. I did.
I just don't understand. Why wouldn't Bragg want to come with us?
He built this place. Would you be able to leave that behind?
Good point.
Oh, Jesus. Look at that.
Oh, God. It's awful.
Christ, what happened here?
What's awful? What, the fucking door against my own?
What do we do to deserve this?
Yeah. Let us out. We are starving, freezing. I read this last time. Can't see nothing. Can hear a lot of stuff, but I can't see nothing. Actually, might be worth it to go and have a little look. What do you think? What do you think? What do you think's down here? Oh. What the?
Let me go. Just let me go home. I just want to see my family again.
What's up with you? You're as white as a sheet.
Why are you standing there? Just fucking checking stuff out, don't I? You know? That's the point of me in there. Might as well take the 2 minutes to try and talk to you guys about, like, maybe some games I got coming up that I'm going to record and do for you. Just in case you wanted to take a look at it, in case you weren't going to get them yourselves. Thinking about getting Moss, which is coming out soon now, a couple of weeks. Gordon Bennett, you look horrible. I got Moss coming out in a few weeks. That's quite cute. Really cute little mouse that you can play as. I was talking. I know what you've got hidden, boy. So got Moss coming out, which is a VR game which you play as a cute little mouse, and it's like a puzzle game. Puzzle game. It's a puzzle puzzle.
Wait, we don't know what's out there.
There was nothing out there before.
Let's just go one at a time.
Oh, no.
One of those things shows up, don't move a fucking muscle.
Oh, shit. Oh, she's gotta die either way, isn't she? This sucks. It's really dark out there.
I'll go first.
So yeah, I got Moss coming out, I got Shadow of the Colossus coming out. It's an old game, Shadow of the Colossus, I love it. I really want to do it because I've been watching Jacksepticeye playing it and I really want to have a taste of it myself. Going to do a couple of recordings on that. Yeah, Moss, puzzle game, Little Mouse, got that for VR coming out. That looks good. I can't think of any others at the moment. I know I've got a few. I've got a few in mind.
Okay, I'm next. When I get to the other side, I'll give the signal.
Diddy? Shadow puppets on the wall. Hey, you got fucking problems in your ears. What if I could, like, stick my head inside your head? Don't worry, it's okay. Right. I sent you out first last time.
You next, or am I?
I'll go. You wait, you. I will be back.
I'll follow.
Don't get dead this time. Oh fuck, I'm gonna get dead. Oh god. Oh god, they're doing it like what they did in fucking Gone. Oh my word, that was cool. I wish I'd done that last time. Fucking UFOs keep on playing up. Oh, Ted, man.
All right, easy. Take it
easy. Dude. Come on, Suzanne. You can do it this time. It should work, shouldn't it? How the fuck are you so tall? Ted. You coming over? Or do I have to go, like, in? Oh, she made it! Oh, man! I wish I'd done that last time. That's so cool. Oh, my legs. Well, at least I got her to stay alive this time. Oh, badass. Oh, but the cops. Oh, shit.
You all have no idea how lucky you are to be alive. Rack doesn't offer much in the way of choices, does he? What happened to the old fool?
Uh-oh.
He wouldn't listen to reason. Guess he wanted to go out on his own terms.
Oh, yes. Well, if Bragg had made up his mind, there's nothing on heaven or earth that would have changed it. Father Ted Mosley, I'm glad to meet another survivor.
Yeah, Father, us too, man.
The only reason we're alive right now is because you told us not to move. At first, I couldn't believe it, but...
I saw it all from here. I'm glad you made it back here.
My magic lamp.
Not everyone has been so lucky today.
Oh, I can't believe she's alive. That's cool.
I've been telling you about the story of these things. I never knew how true it all was.
I don't have to feel guilty this time.
This is not a disease. This is not a virus. This is a curse. There are more survivors holed up in the administration offices. They still think it's an infection. They have no idea what they're up against.
There's that thing up there, but we don't have to go for that.
I've been so worried about each and every one of you.
Me too,
I warned Bragg something like this could happen.
I know.
I warned him there was something here on the mountain. An evil spirit, powerful. But he wouldn't listen.
And he didn't believe you?
Said I'd lost my grip. Said there are no such things as evil spirits. I even started doubting myself. But now...
What do you suggest we do?
We have to wait.
Police
will be here soon.
Yeah.
They have to be.
Yeah, they will.
I advise everyone to get a little shut-eye while we can.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Yeah, ta-da. Let's get a little bit of sleep before the cops come here and kill us all.
Just hold tight. They're coming to get us out of this.
Oh, look at them.
How are we going to get out of this?
They keep coming.
You think the police are really on their way?
Oh.
Hey. Don't be scared. They'll be here soon.
Get in there, David Sandry! Oh, okay. Let's hope so.
Sooner the better.
It's
yeah.
Okay. It's gonna be fine.
Duh.
Listen, we should get some shut-eye before the cops show up.
She just sit there like... Hey, Gordon, man.
You gotta prefer to be alone. I'm not feeling myself.
You don't have a choice!
I'd advise you to do the same.
You always knew what was best for me, didn't you, Gordo? Do you remember those times we shared? Oh.
I need some time to myself.
Yeah, you all fucking... You all do, don't you?
Get some rest before the police arrive.
I'm gonna go up there and fucking burn everything now, right? If you don't fucking start talking to me. Just want someone to talk to. Just want friends. what is book? I'm attacking my own fucking room. Look, hidden panels under the floorboards. No, there's not. Wait, can I actually see through the fucking door? Nope. I can actually see through gaps in the door. I can see the cops before they come here and kill us all. Well, I best get to this then. And that's why you don't mess around with the fucking controllers. Look, it's pitch black out there. Well, yeah, I mean, it's night time. It should be. Cock-a-doodle-doo. Oh, it's so cute that them two like that now. Which is going to make it worse if he does get fucking hurt. I'm hoping I can get, like, what, a different ending this time now that she's, like, there. Maybe she'll, like, stick up for me or something. I can only hope. Now, I just want to check this door just to make sure it's 100% locked. It is locked. Right.
You're playing with fire, Brad. There's something bigger than the two of us at work in this place, and we've got to be careful.
I see you. See you down there. I see you.
What you're saying is ludicrous.
Still barefoot. You, like, you go barefoot throughout this whole game. It's fucking stupid, isn't it? Oh. I keep on disconnecting my fucking my PlayStation VR thingy. It's because I can't see where the cables are, you see? Because I'm inside this fucking editing. Doesn't help I got a small room. It is just not good for VR. Not in any way. If you really want to get the most out of a VR game, have yourself a big room to play it in. Right, well, I've had a look up there. Cops are about to come in the morning, I'll kill everyone. I'm going to sleep as close as I can to the door this time, so I don't have much of a walk. It's time to go to sleep. So yeah, there we go. How much sleep did we get? 2 seconds worth? I don't know. Oh, please don't let her die now in this bit. Be fucking well gutted. Oh, he's gonna ask me to do this awkward fucking opening the door scene again, haven't he? Can't see through there now, look.
Would you please come and help me?
Sure. Let's do it. Grim.
I'm so sorry. This will all be over soon.
Hey, I see you down there. Yeah, I was deflecting bullets, and yeah. Oh, please don't say anyone's dead. But this is where
go.
I went. Whoa!
Go! Keep moving!
Yes.
Don't stop!
Yes.
I can't keep running.
You can do it, Suzanne. Come on.
Stop.
Oh, wait. Please don't say someone's hurt.
Great. Now what the hell do we do?
This house head this way. Gotta be right under it.
David, help me with the door.
Yeah.
Why can't I see the door?
Come on.
Such a pointless scene just doing all this in the dark, but I get it because I think I've been shot.
Hey.
Whoa! Hey, we're all here! Woohoo! My arm is stuck down there, pal. What happened? Cool.
Let's just take it easy for now.
No bullet holes.
You nearly caught a bullet with your skull.
Yeah, bullet holes.
I could tumble and hit your head pretty hard. You'll be alright.
Officer, we gotta keep moving. No time.
Not everyone can keep up with you, Gordon.
Open fire like that.
The police saw the miner, what he'd become, and they reacted.
Yes.
Reacted?
Reacted.
People are dead, man. That's a pretty big fucking reaction.
Yes.
I think we all need to calm down.
We do, don't we? Yes, yes. I don't know.
Are you hearing that?
What?
It was a misunderstanding. That's all it was. We just need to explain it to them.
Godo, why is no one ever paying attention to you, pal? We shouldn't go back.
The police know we saw what they did. That makes us witnesses. We need to get out of here. This tunnel will take us to the hotel, and from there...
Okay.
Off the mountain.
Yes.
Can they walk?
Can I walk?
Keep your eyes on my finger.
Okay, not my head, my eyes, okay. It's right there. Got it? Yeah?
Response seems normal.
Well, you don't seem normal.
Oh, shut up. I'm trying to think.
Do you really not hear all these voices?
Gordon, there are no voices.
Don't worry, boys.
You're just lying to me. Of course there are. They won't stop.
He's a bit,
Take it easy. Get off of me.
No, Doc. What your problem?
Knob. Don't stress about him too much. He's just he's going through a hard time, you know. I mean, he did voluntarily get locked up with me, you know.
Can you stand?
You'll be fine.
Yeah.
One step at a time.
Yeah. Help me up. Let's do it.
You can do it.
Ah, so they bought it all out off behind me.
Let's go.
So they bought it all out off. What's behind that, and how do we... Fucking hell. Got it? They love each other. They just don't want
to
admit it.
Giving up on that door.
I know.
It won't be long before they find another way in. No. We should go.
What's with the sparkly floor? There's not even any light above this.
How are you holding up?
Miners and the police? If this is all a terrible dream, I just want to wake up. Or at least get off this mountain.
We should be safe in the hotel.
It's like what Jason does when he's like in a forest and he's always like, shh, shh, shh. But then like taking on and just taking a complete piss out of it, but going,
knows this place like the back of his hand. If anyone could make it, it's him.
Yeah. Is this a thing? Hello? Hello? Never mind. Jesus Christ. You could have scared me to death then, young man. I don't even get to see what's in there.
Victor, is that you?
Probably, listen about.
Jesus fuck!
What
all
gets...
Right. Show's over.
He looks down there, right? He looks down there, but nothing gets chucked there. Look at that. Do you see anything on this floor? Look at that. Nothing. I don't know what it is he's looking at.
Victor manages to cram the entire hotel in here for the winter.
Does he? Victor's
look
a good guy.
Organized.
Hey, he's a lovely
bloke. Cleanliness is next to godliness.
Oh, I know.
Sets a fine example.
Well, yeah.
He said you have to stay focused.
Oh, I know, dude. Believe me. Holy shit, no. I don't know what, like, what's, those memory things.
Like been here,
they usually glow like this, so I can tell what they are. But they're not always shining, so you've got to be a bit more intuitive. What's on the news? Vic, boy. Oh.
I'm telling you, this sort of press really gets under Bragg's skin. I'd advise you to be careful.
Okay. I can be careful. You saw nothing. It's the same. It's glowing in the darkness.
The scratches in the walls and ship you. I don't want to know what's down there, to be honest. Too scared. A lot of these places are like dead ends. It's like I remember going in here and there was nothing in here. You guys holding hands then? Oh. I hope that these two get out of here at least. I can at least have somewhat of a happy ending if these two can get out here. Right, so it's coming.
Pines Hotel.
Yeah.
The elevator up ahead will get us there.
Fucking, where's the minibar? Where's the bar? Take me to a bar.
You hear that?
Aye.
What was it?
Don't know.
I don't know.
You don't know. I don't know. Nobody knows. It's the Wendigo, it is. It's the Wendigo. Here he is, look, Nutter. I always thought when I was watching the past recording that I did on this scene here of him banging the wall over his hand, it sounds exactly like that guy that slams his head against the wall in Outlast.
I'm sorry I pushed you. I don't know what came over me.
Ah. You're all going to see what came over him, I can tell you that.
You heard them, right? The voices?
Dr. Bennett, there are no voices. I'm worried you might be malnourished. It could be affecting your perception.
Nonsense. I'm perfectly fine. You don't seem yourself, Dr. Bennett.
Oh, God.
I'm going to keep an eye on you.
What's for soup, vampires? Oh, look, there's a bottle there. What is that? That's a knife.
Come on. Don't fall behind. Elevator's this way.
Yeah, give me 2 seconds, guys. Happy couple, look at them. Oh. I'm just going to have a quick look around here, because there's a bottle. I never got to see this last time. I'm picking up a few bits and bobs from last time now that I never got to see. It's down here, dead end. That's all right. That's all right. Look, there's a bottle here. Time to get drunk. Do you want to get pissed at me? Might as well, now. Right. Old Randy. Let's get Randy!
Well now, doctor.
Oh.
I can only hope you have better.
I miss you, Vic. Good luck. We going away? Just wanted a quick swig before we went. We're a bit stressed, you know. I really want to stay away from those. Oh, they're ovens. They're not bloody, I thought they were like those things that bodies are stored in. Those cadaver tables that, like, slide in. Now, the elevator scene I wanted to talk about coming up soon, because this is coming towards the end now. Once we all jump in the elevator, that's pretty much you go towards the end of the game. But, like, everything can change here. Like, David can get shot. Maybe she could die this time. We can meet Vic again. Loads of different things can happen. I'm wondering if there's a way that you can actually get every single person out of you. Because I'm pretty sure there's a way. Because when I finished the game, it said that you did not convince Bragg to leave with you. Are you done? Yeah, so when I finished the game last time, it said, like, oh, you did not convince Bragg to leave with you, so and so. Oh. Hello, Leggy. Go on. So I'm wondering if there's a way you can actually convince him to go with you, too. I'm wondering if that's a thing. So there might actually be a way to get everyone to follow you. But what I'll do is I'll play it at another time, because I got other games that I want to play at the moment and stuff, so I'm just going to leave it at this, get this ending maybe, try something different.
Alright, enter the elevator. Quiet.
Sorry, I wasn't doing nothing. Sorry, David.
Go ahead.
Sorry, I was gonna touch your poop or something, you know.
Got to get out of here. Now!
No! 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 Oh, and he's gonna die from that. Son of a bitch.
Oh, this is not good.
No.
This is not good.
He's gonna go nuts next.
It's gonna be okay. Just push down.
He's gonna go nuts next.
Okay.
Maybe she'll save him.
Feeling faint.
There.
Come on, Davy boy.
Almost.
We're almost out.
Gordon, can you do anything for him?
I can stand you looking like a tart. Oh. So he should die. That should mean that Vic is coming along this time.
Looks like it got hit by one of the bullets.
What? Ah, right.
Damn it.
That's why.
What now?
I know just how that panel feels.
Oh, no. Oh, no, it's the police again.
I didn't press nothing. You open him up, boy.
They're coming back to finish the job.
Shit. You need to pull your finger out, boy. You stop standing in front where bullets can fly through. We should be standing at the sides, where bullets can't touch us. I don't have the skills anymore to karate chop through bullets. Right, so it should be...
Everyone just...
Oh, so these guys die here. I want to see her reaction this time. The Wendigo comes here now, kills two guards. I want to see what she's like when this happens. Hey, guys.
You've got to get out of here.
You think he's dangerous? Fucking, you want to watch him, boy? Right, where are we going? First floor? Lobby.
This is the lobby. We can't stay here.
Basement? First floor. Let's go first floor.
What in God's name are you doing?
Well, I don't know.
Are still down there.
I don't know. Is that badge on you? Ooh, ah. Right, Vic should be on now, isn't it?
Don't shoot!
Watch him. Go on, son. Get in there. Yeah. Good on you, lad. Good on you. Go, Gordo. I wonder what'll happen if I don't press anything. He's just gonna get up off air now and he's gonna fucking lie. He's gonna have us now, isn't he? God. What the hell? I didn't press anything. So Gordon went down there this time, so he didn't make it this time either, so it's just a slot. Maybe there is no way you can get everyone to get out here. Because it's so random, because every character just does their own thing. Like, if I replay this situation again now, it might be it.
Victor? Second floor! We'll make for the cable car!
No, Victor, no! Victor was there! Oh, no. Oh, I remember sharing a bottle of whiskey with him. Good times. He was a nice bloke, he was. I liked him. So, yeah, it's like so random, this elevator. It's weird. I don't quite understand it, because I could replay the same thing now where you start off downstairs when you first get on the elevator, and David might not get shot that time. You know, Gordo, he might still be in the elevator at that point and might not go nuts. So it's, I don't know, strange, it's random, it's weird. But David's going to die now, it's just going to be me, Suzanne, Ted. I know. I know, buddy. Sorry. I love David, he's brilliant.
Nice damn block. It!
He's the first bloke we meet. That's like really nice to us and helps us out of this
look
mess.
At me spilling out.
Hey, look at me. Hold on. Just a little longer. Come on.
O'Connor.
Oh, David. Farewell.
Goodbye, David. Sleep now.
No! You. You did this!
Suzanne, please. This is no time to turn on each other.
It's just me and you then.
Get in the car. I'll make sure you all get off the mountain.
Go. Go on, go. I want to talk to him a minute.
Just go, please.
No, Father, I'll stay.
I need to do this. This is the right thing for me to do.
It's stupid saying it, even though I know I'm not going to stay. No, I'm staying. I'm staying.
Don't be stupid. There's no reason for you to stay here. You're just going to get us all killed.
All right, but thank you. Do you want to do the whole thing again? I don't know. Maybe it'll help towards something. I don't fucking know.
Welcome. Nice to know that all are welcome.
Yeah.
Even hot shit reporters.
Yeah, I know.
Not a word of me in your story, or there's no deal.
Okay.
All right.
So this is where we find out I'm a reporter. I get it. Okay. I never even thought to look down last time. Alright, son. Come on out, Suzanne. Let's get out here.
You. David would still be here.
It's not my fault.
It's your fault.
What do you blame me for? What in the hell? Stuff's going through the fucking... Look, I guess it's my fault then. At least it'll be interesting seeing it now with her being. Oh, come on. Anna Bennett, Gordon Mann, I didn't even know who Anna was. Suzanne Daniels. I'll never be free. Victor Milgram. And when my lips, when we die,
puts out the fire. Though I may try and try,
no one can satisfy
this longing in me.
I'll never be free.
No, no.
From your smile so tender, the sweet surrender in your eyes.
How can I be free when I still remember how you could thrill me with a sigh, just like a chain bound to my heart. Your love remains when we're apart. Each kiss I gave to you
made me a slave.
I don't think it's going to make much difference at the end, because it's just going to be them two choices again, isn't it? Either I end up in the nut house or I promise to keep my mouth shut to that cop. I'd rather go with the one that's saying, oh, I'll keep my mouth shut, because at least that way he lets me go. Well, I think he does, anyway, I can't really remember.
Like a chain bound to my heart, your love remains when we're apart. Each kiss I gave to you made me a slave.
Minor, forgive me if they made me a king. I'll never be free. Stormy weather and Tennessee waltz. Isn't that a lovely song? Cred, this is still going on. This is a problem. Yeah, so I mean, cool. I think it went wrong somewhere, because the credits supposed to usually end along with the song, and then you get that little thing at the end with a cop. It just shouldn't be too long now with credits. But I got a feeling these credits are just like replaying over and over and over. I'm trying to see if I like recognize any of the names or anything that I've seen previously up the list. I ain't got a clue. It's too many bloody names. So yeah, I could now then, after this whole cop thing, I could then go back, test it again. This, that time, because like last time I did it, it was random again. It was like, because I think it goes by whichever floor you press to as well. That's the trick. So I could try it again, press a different floor. Maybe go straight up for Victor. What floor was he on? Floor one, wasn't it? So yeah, I could go straight to floor one, get Victor. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what floor he's on. Fucker. Oh, my back. Are we done your Ottawa? We fucking done Ottawa. Jesus. Come on. It's a shame. It's stupid that you can't skip the credits. Special thanks to Asia Font. The events and characters depicted in this... I ain't got time to... Blackwood Pines Sanatorium. And Bernie. Right, done. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck, I shit myself in.
Look at me. I'm a reasonable man.
It's a nice gun.
So let's get down to business.
Okay.
You say you saw all sorts of bad stuff up on Blackwood Mountain.
Who? Me?
But I say...
No.
You broke into a reputable institution under false pretenses.
Yeah, I did.
Who do you think people are going to believe?
Me. Because I'll be telling them, I just want to go home. I just want to go home. I want to go home. Want to go home.
Silence. A good strategy. Especially when it comes to publishing stories, no one will believe.
Oh, I could stay silent.
Yeah, that's right. I know all about you. Your editor's been worried sick. As much as I'd like to see you just disappear, this puts me in a bit of a squeeze.
You know, it's like
and I don't like to be squeezed.
It's like what The Walking Dead taught me from them games. Staying silent is still an option.
Our editor, See? Reasonable.
Hi.
Just like me. Now, let's get you home, huh?
Why am I scratching my tip?
Just remember, I'll be watching.
Me in the shower. Because you're a perv. Right then, little bit of a scare scare now.
I see it now. It's so simple, it's so easy.
Really? Okay, so that's the end of it. I'm just going to take you guys in and check a few bits and bobs from here. This is how I know, like, the characters' names and stuff. So you can't click on any of these, but you can just stare at them and they wiggle about and stuff. Don't see the point in that, really, to be honest with you. Okay, so this time I did all these. Deadly crosshead. You kept still when crossing the courtyard. David made it to the chapel alive. Suzanne made it to the chapel alive. Ted was glad you made it to the chapel. Safely. You kept still. Okay. So we did this. You resisted the temptation. Bennett was taken from your room. Abe and Victoria were killed. Bennett complained of hearing voices. Bennett became the Wendigo. So maybe those are options of something. Maybe I can stop him from becoming a Wendigo. You were honest with David. You earned David's trust. Yeah, well, I like David. He's a nice bloke. That's all it says about him. You sided with Suzanne. Suzanne blamed herself for not convincing Bragg to leave. So you can, I think you can get him to go with you. And we got Suzanne encouraged you to get out of the wheelchair. Okay, so that's all from there. And the interrogation. You convinced the police you'd keep the truth secret. The police released you without charge. So there's loads of different things I can do. I will go back to it and I will change things. But I'll do it all another date. I just want to take a little chill away from the game at the moment and wait for some new stuff to come along. But if you've enjoyed these episodes, please hit the subscribe button. Subscribe to me. So that when I do new videos, you can check out them too.